look out in the Swain Lady Devil Sopta here on the Massive YouTube. And Jerry here at Kevin's Clouds and the Threat of Rain. Just ready to get rolling. Baseball has already started next door. Of course, the scoreboard working, so with the baseboard and update you there. Sopta, we're ready to go. And we have our work cut out for us today. Coming in, the Hiwassee Dam Lady Eagles, a fantastic softball team, finishing sixth this year to the state championship, losing in three games, and this team is already off to a 7-0 start this season. As a matter of fact, over the years, we have battled probably Hiwassee Dam tougher than anybody. Last year, we lost a close one 3-1 over at Hiwassee Dam, and today, we're just looking to come back and build off those really good plays that we saw against Robbinsville. Tried a really good ball game because this is a fantastic team. Hiwassee has not lost a conference game since losing to Hayesville 4 years ago. That's right, 4 years ago, they were conference co-champions with Hayesville that year. But after that, they have won every single year. So they've won, I think, three Smoky Mountain Conference championships in a row. Last year, they went all the way to the state championship contest before they lost to North Duplin. Hiwassee Dam actually won the first game of the series, 7-0. They lost 2-1 championship game. In the best of three, they lost that one by score to three. But this is a very solid team. Star Dub and the first ball here, and there's going to be a fine effort against Robbins in that three game. Found good deeps over there at space. Tucker for number one. Out again on Wix. Up over under her going to be Macy Sienna. And of course, following her in the number four spot is Haley Shope, the all everything for Hiwassee Dam. Pitch in, just missing inside. Wow. I tell you, in the early going, we're seeing Taylor Day with some really good control. She's putting it in the strike zone, it looks like, from here. But according to the man in blue behind the plate, might be a little inside, might be a little outside. Pitch in. This one is in for a call strike. So, again, Taylor had a good day against Robbinsville. We had some good defense in that ball game. We got some hitting that really got going late. Let's see if we can duplicate that effort here today. Here's a shot in the right field, going to be in for a base hit. And rounding first and heading to second is going to be Karen Forrester, and she's in with a stand-up double. So Hiwassee Dam with their first base runner of the day on, and that's going to bring up Macy Sienna, their starting first baseman and number three hitter, with Haley Shope on deck. And Haley Shope is going to be in the pitcher's circle today for Hiwassee Dam. And Haley Shope, again, is just one of those outstanding athletes you might see once every, maybe even every 10 years. I mean, she is that good, but more about her later. Right now, our Lady Devils trying to get Hiwassee Dam out in the inning. One down, runner on second. And Sienna, the batter. Again, the starting first baseman for the undefeated Hiwassee Dam Lady Eagles. Pitch in, just missing outside for a ball. Again, boys baseball with Hiwassee Dam going on next door. We'll keep an eye on those foul balls that might come our way as we're conveniently perched between the softball and baseball fields. Pitch outside, missing. So again, no, they're going to call it a strike, kind of a delayed strike. The ump kind of slow in getting his hand up there to signal the strike call. So we'll try to keep an eye on that for you as we now have a 2-1 count with one out. Taylor of the windup and the throw. This one is going to be in for a ball, 2-2 now. Just getting underway here on the top of the first inning. Will we be able to finish this game? Well, of course, that depends on the weather as we are facing a rain situation. Swing and a miss for a strike two. Good pitch in as Taylor gets the strike on Macy Sienna. So now we got to, looks like a full count going 3-2 with one out. Runner at second base. Hiwassee Dam, a very aggressive base running team. They will run. Pitch in, just missing for a ball four. So that's going to put runners on first and second now with one down. And Haley, North Carolina, won a stake. And she do absolutely. Show up again for a strike. Show up again, an outstanding player offensively and offensively with a great and at the plate. Pitch in, ground, runs third and score. So Haley up with a really high hop the middle with the first RBI of the ball game. Hiwassee Dam's Lady Eagles 2-1 and a 1-0 lead. One out here on the top of the first inning now. As batting now is going to be Alicia Floyd. She is their starting catcher for the Eagles. High. Alley going into the baseball diamond. Going to land on the third and in the lead in the Smoky Mountain Conference as they're undefeated. That pitch in the dirt, and that's going to allow the runners to advance on a wild pitch. So the runners move up to now second and third for the Lady Eagles of Hiwassee Dam. Offensively, and that's impressive. 365. Pitch in the dirt again for all. Runners holding up now at second and third. Empty for Alicia Lloyd. Again, extension. Digs in. Our Taylor Day with a windup. Another well-hit ball right off of the glove of the shortstop. And will score. Throw on down to third, not in time. And holding up at first, diving back in, is going to be Alicia Floyd. Again, off the top of the glove of our shortstop, Grace Kate. So we're going to call that a base hit. And Alicia Floyd on first with an unusual number, 99. Kind of a means numbering off that. Will be a pinch run. Coming in now, it'll be Brittany Sims. A pinch run. They only have two people on the substitute list here for Hiwassee Dam. So they are only two. Everybody else gets in there and play. Here comes the runner, already going down to first base. She would have gone, but the pitch is through easily. Now at base in this 2-0 ball game. As already two RBIs in the early. Floyd, one out. Two thing with one out. First now. One up by Taylor Day. Ground ball right up the middle. Going to be a base hit. Going to score at least one run. Pitch coming into second base over there from center. And two more runs are in. So Hiwassee Dam now with four here in the top of the first inning. Solid season. But facing the toughest lineup in the conference right now. Pitch is going to be in the dirt and actually hit the batter. So the batter is going to be on first base. Now with a hit batter. That's Megan Golden. Hit by a pitch. Just kind of got her a little bit on the foot, as it was in the dirt, so no run made. Player batting now for the Eagles. Seeing some pitching in the dirt here in the first inning. Trying to keep Hiwassee Dam with the pitching from today because they are super fun. Smitting. That's calls now. Only one on first and second. Hiwassee the four. Top of the first thing here. Ladies trying to get count. Samantha Willingham on the line. Coach Hinton. And he had a lot of talent. Probably the main anyway. Space. It's going to get Shields. The circle lead. And then he's got his coming out on the same page. For our coaching still be bulletin. Ashton Miller workles. The umpires are out to talk. Hasse Dash talks to Toby Zion. Not sure the guest put it out. Scoreboard's not working. Baseball diamond. Here on the top ball scoreboard, 4-0. Lady Eagles in the lead as the coaches and the umpire continue to discuss. Lady Devils looking at this jewel down the road. After today's game, we're coming up next week. Then on March, and that's going to be a home game, by the way, Blue Ridge here on March 29. So try to come in because that's going to be the first week. Pisgah, April 1st, Sville, April 5th at Cherry. Then we come back home. It's game April 6th with Smoky Mountain. Then back on the road at Blue Ridge, April 8th. Final team is April 9th in runs and at Hiwassee Dam, last game of the regular. And we've talked, it was a 3 at Hiwassee Dam. If these players are the same that were in the runners, every base. The bases are low. Again for Willingham, right fielder. She digs in. We can tell already first inning, not giving much. That, and it is 1-1 count now. The strike in. Girl pitching the count. I want to in their gray rim. Their colors are on the color. Their shot just foul down the third base. She have used very spicy this afternoon. Grim, say third color. That is becoming a trend. We're seeing third color. So school. Kalibal team started then to third color. So these schools have been doing that for several years, and that has trickled down to the high schools. Which is well right at our left field. We've got play. It's a fine throw in. So a good job out there in left field by Aaron Jones to pull that one down for number two with the bases loaded. That's been a two-run shot. Caught a good job of the field and a good throw into the run. And now Hiwassee back to the time as Kate Wiggins, who started off with first out of the day, popped a steps in with two. For the lady. Can't she? The inning started with Dill. She led off, but right now, base loaded. Want to get it out and get our turn to bat. Side for a ball. 2-0. A lot of pitches here in the first inning for Taylor Day. Really good work. Taylor, a fine game Tuesday, and that's a dramatic loss to Rob for a one count now. Again, with two. Is very concerned about the ability to game in before the rain. Because we're going to cut a scale of rain. So look for all. Bases loaded. Eagles. One run here. Another day has got a ground ball in play to the short over at first. Run again. A shot right at Grace Kim. She knocked it down. Didn't quite handle. Back now is going to be this first. Top. They will have field back, but catch it. Good game by Jack to end the inning. And the Lady Eagles will go to the dugout to be on bench tomorrow. Finally, with this time.
Been running behind thing for important projects that directly impact education. Not all projects, but the work was established to help program would otherwise be canceled. A few of these programs, supported by the Maroon Strong Fund, are the Summer STEM Camp, where students are able and OneSG supplies all students grade 4 with their own personal laptop. Keep you up to date on how the fund is doing through our social media outlets, such as Facebook and the Maroon Devils Network. Thanks for all your support. Strong and Education Fund for Swain Schools, Community Service Swain, Inc., a 501(c)(3) organization.
Fans, welcome back. Here we go with the bottom of the first inning. Now some runs back and right back in this game. Smith, as we kick off the shortstop, Ware 23 followed Kinzad's call, hit 3 against one of the dominant players in all these show. But I don't want to keep Bryant or Lady Dale facing Tunis. But they've got side as throws it right back to his show in the pitcher's circle. Haley, again, one of those rare players. She's all conference, and I'm 99% sure of this, all conference in softball, volleyball, and basketball. She is one of those, again, dramatic, very talented athletes. You may tend to see how level that along every year. It just didn't happen. In fact, it didn't happen that much, even at the 4A level, when you have a player who's all comp and capable of going on and playing collegiate. Haley Shope is going to be doing that next season. She is already committed and is going to be playing college athletics next year. Another foul ball off the bat. About more Grace, one senior. This late, that's our bat. Down the lineup for our Lady Devils. Pitch high for a ball. So Grace Cabe is a Patel on base. Aaron Adams, Sydney Call is on deck. And the rain has started. Swain County High School, a little rain moving in already. Have wind, and it may only get worse. Chun Senior, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 junior in our starting lineup here today. That will be a lot of folks back next season. Foul ball, so out of play again. Meanwhile, Hiwassee Dam has really been riding the talent of the senior class 4 straight years. So next year might be a little different scene over for the Lady Eagles. Pitch high fall. Haley Shope trying to slow down and in the groove here. And what does Haley Shope is in it as probably any pitcher anywhere. She really done. There's a foul ball. It's going to be caught. It was popped up in there behind the plate, and it's going to be caught for out number 2 off the bat of Aaron Jenkins. So a tough pop foul, and batting down is going to be talking about to Haley Shope. She's a lot of good stuff. Throws a mid to high 50s, has an outstanding curveball, and that's her best pitch. There's a ball in play. Third baseman can't handle it. An error over at third, rounding second, coming into third safely. And we have runners on second and third off the bat of Sydney Call. So the shortstop couldn't hang on. And Sydney winds up at second base, and down at third is Grace Cabe. So now our Lady Devils with one out, with potentially some runners on. And now their coach, Coach Helton, coming out to talk with this pitcher and talking about, the outstanding talent of Haley. But again, she throws it really hard, mid to high 50s, and that's pretty off. Now, curveball, which is her best pitch, and it breaks away from right-handed hitters, which makes it even more effective, and she has a very good changeup. But she can hit any pitch out of the ballpark as well when she's at bat with her power. She's a very strong young lady and very, very athletic. And now the looks like even the umpire has gone to get a jacket. The base ump is pulling his get on. Now they're with base runners on second and third and only one out. A little bit concerned. Goes over to talk to his infield and defense and to Haley Shope. We have heard here. So now Elizabeth coming on to bat. Our sophomore right fielder, Caitlin Dills, is going to be on deck, our only senior. Some fastball there for a strike. But let's see if we can get a run across the plate here, or a couple, actually, only one down. Pitch high for a ball. And again, the rain's continuing to increase a little bit. I think we can play on this for a little bit. Lighter. Umbrellas are out. Swing and a miss. And that's going to run the count to 1-2 now. Runners on second and third. Number 14, our sophomore right matchup. Did she go around? I'm afraid so. And the base ump will agree. So that's going to be strike three. And that is, believe it or not, the first strikeout of the day by either pitcher. As Caitlin Dills, our designated player, now stepping in. Two out, but again, runners at second and third. Let's see if we can get a couple of runs in here off the bat of Caitlin. Pitch in, call strike. Haley Shope with a big blue ribbon in her hair. Of course, Hiwassee and Am wearing a little bit of blue. They're blue and white, but a lot of gray in their uniforms here this afternoon. Of course, our Lady Devils and our traditional maroon and white. Over on the baseball diamond, everybody has white pants. Our Maroon Devils in maroon jerseys and Hiwassee Dam in blue jerseys. Pitch low for a ball. So now with two out, the count runs 1-2. Lady Eagles up 5-0. But we have runners in scoring position here. We just need a hit to get them in. There's a foul ball. So now the question is, with some rain already, how much will we get to play before the rain might call it a day for both games? Oh, pitch in. That's going to be a call, third strike. So we leave two stranded. And again, that blazing fastball from Haley Shope gets us at the batter's box. So after one, it's 5-0 Hiwassee Dam. Stay tuned. Top of the second coming up.
Having trouble getting out of bed? Wake up late? Are you too late to get breakfast? Can't stay awake in class? Good thing there is Second Chance Breakfast. Now that's better. There are three ways to enjoy Second Chance Breakfast. You can grab breakfast just before first period starts and bring it with you to class on time. You can go to class first, check in with your teacher, and then quickly grab breakfast to bring back to class. Or you can grab breakfast between first and second period and take it with you to second period. Be sure to get permission from your teachers before leaving class or bringing food into the classroom.
Fans, welcome back. One inning gone here in a potential rain situation at Swain County High School with baseball and softball versus Hiwassee Dam. And our girls back on defense now, trying to slow down this juggernaut that is Hiwassee Dam. Again, their team batting average 365. They have four home runs as a team and 65 RBIs. And they are number one in the state, 7-0 overall. Ground ball to third base over to first. Easy play and a good job defensively over there. As handling it with no problem, Gabby Jones fires on over to Shani Katoster for one down. So their hitter, Macy Senna, is now 0-for-2 on the day as she grounds out to third base. Haley Shope had an RBI single last time up. Haley, kind of a streaky hitter, but has the power to hit it out. And again, one of those, she was all state last year as Hiwassee Dam lost the state championship as they played three games against North Duplin, and they won the first game and lost the next two. But Shope, an athlete that's worth the price of admission, if you know what I mean. You don't see those athletes come along very often that can excel at so many sports at such a high level. Good pitch from Taylor Day. That one is going to be in for a call strike now. 2-1 the count on Haley Shope with one down. The wind still whipping around. A little bit of rain, nothing hard so far. Oh, that one looks like it might have hit off the leg of Taylor Day. That one just kind of rolls in and well in front of the batter. Now, the forecasters say the heavy rain is supposed to be tonight. We'll see if that's the case here as we're in the second inning. And Taylor gets her shoe put back on in the right position and lost her shoe there. And looks like she's ready to go now with one down. And nobody on for Hiwassee Dam. The Lady Eagles batting now on the top of the second inning with a 5-0 lead. The windup and the throw from Taylor. High pop is going to be trouble, but good job. Drifting back over there at second base. Outstanding job by Sydney Call. When that came off the bat, I thought it was going to be in for a single. One of those first, but Sydney back pulling. It's already two quick outs. And this is the top hitters in the order as well. So number three and four batters down. Elisa Floyd batting now. She has a single and an RBI last. Pitch in. Good pitch right across the knees for a strike. Again, the ump calling it tight here, not giving much. Taylor with a windup on the 0-1. This one is fouled off out of play, just off the top of the dugout. Occupied right now by the Lady Eagles of Hiwassee Dam. A team we're trying to knock off. They are 7-0. They're undefeated in conference play. The way the conference stands right now, Hiwassee Dam 5-0, Robbinsville 6-1, Rosman 5-1, Our Lady Devils 3-2, Andrews 3-3, Hayesville 2-3, Murphy 1-6, Cherokee 0-4 in conference play as of today. Ground ball right up the middle. That's a clean base hit. Handled well out in center field. Good job defensively out there again by Our Lady Devils. Briar Buchanan throws it on in now. So Hiwassee Dam, their first base runner of the second inning. And a two-for-two day for Alicia Floyd. A Savannah Wills had a single last time up now for hitting for the Lady Eagles. Our Lady Devils again next game. Going to be right here at home with Blue Ridge next week. And then we have some road games coming up. So after today, we only have four home games left. We have Blue Ridge, Smoky Mountain, Andrews, and Murphy here at home in softball. Quick jump off the base down there at first base, and that's a pitch runner, Brittany Sims, jumping off first base. No throw down by our catcher, Callan Brown. Another hard shot right up the gut. Oh, this one gets by our center fielder. This one's going to be for extra bases. The runner is being waved on around third and will score. And with a stand-up double and an RBI is Savannah Willis. That ball hit the grass, and I'm sure the grass is a little wet. And if you've ever played softball or baseball, if it comes in on a line drive, it just takes off. The ball hits the wet grass, and it's almost like it hits another gear, and it just – it's so hard to corral when it hits the grass that's just a little bit wet. And, man, that ball just took off and goes all the way to the fence. And that makes it a 6-0 lead now for Hiwassee Dam as we are getting some light rain. And that makes for wet grass. Ground ball to the shortstop, knocks it down on the first, gets the out, and that's going to end the inning. So Hiwassee Dam gets one. Our Lady Devils will try to add some on the scoreboard as we'll be back with the bottom of the second with the Eagles up 6-0 right here on the Maroon Devils Network.
Here's a great way to support Swain County Schools. Your contribution to the Maroon Strong Fund will help provide needed funding for important projects that directly impact our students' education. Not all projects can be supported by state or local funding, so the Maroon Strong Fund was established to help fund programs that would otherwise be canceled. A few of these programs supported by the Maroon Strong Fund are the Summer STEM Camp, where students are able to interact with new technology, and the One-to-One Technology Initiative that supplies all students grade 4 and up with their own personal laptop. We'll keep you up to date on how the fund is doing through our social media outlets such as Facebook and the Maroon Devils Network. Thanks for all your support. The Maroon Strong Fund is an education fund for Swain County Schools operating under Community Services of Swain, Inc., a 501c3 nonprofit organization.
Fans, welcome back. We have rain here at Swain County High School, but so far the umpires are saying let's play on, and here we go. Bottom of the second, our Lady Devils down 6-0 with the first pitch in from Haley Shope. High for a ball. Stepping in is Briar Buchanan, who had a huge game against Robbinsville earlier in the week with a big two RBI hit, and it really got us in the lead there. And then Shani Katoster had a big home run, but it's a huge game. Swing and a miss for a strike now. Lady Eagles with a 6-0 lead, and the rain has started coming down pretty solid right now at Swain County High School. But so far, nobody has called the game. We haven't seen any lightning or thunder, and we'll see how long this lasts. But I have a feeling it's not gonna last long, and we'll see if that holds true. Because from what we could see on the radar, I know Carrie Powell came up here with her cell phone, and we saw Toby Burrows earlier. There's some serious yellow, which means thunderstorms, in that radar picture, and that's never good, as that one has bounced off the backstop. Foul ball by Briar Buchanan. On deck is going to be Shani Katoster and Gabby Jones, batting here on the bottom of the second inning. But the rain is still drizzling down. Well, I shouldn't say drizzle. It's raining steady right now. Ball in the dirt, and it's actually blocked by the catcher's mask. Behind the plate back there is Alicia Floyd. That ball bounced up, caught her right in the mask. And that's one of the dangers as well. If you got a wet baseball or a wet softball, it can have a tendency to get away from a pitcher. And that can be a little bit dangerous in itself. That ball, foul ball down the first base side. Toby Burrell walking back over toward the dugout. And the official gets the ball. Toby gets the ball. They bring in and that's going to be another job right now, is trying to keep the balls even halfway dry in this kind of weather. And again, when it's just a little bit wet, it can get away from a pitcher, either in softball or baseball. Pitch in, and it's going to be a call strike. Catcher dropped it on to first, though, and that's going to be an out as Briar Buchanan leads off here. That's the third strikeout in a row, by the way, by Shope, who had three batters that she struggled with in the bottom of the first inning, but now she's struck out three in a row. Shani Katoster, who had the big home run, two-run homer against Robbinsville on Tuesday. Wow, both teams have been on the scoreboard over on the baseball side of things. They have down to second in the ball game. Shani Katoster stepped out of the box and used to fall. With a whole lot of relief in the fist. I think that one got the umpire. He told a little bit. He's knocked it off a little bit. She has his on it. I'm sure it's still hurt because you can't protect every body back there behind the plate. All right, Shani throwing that bunt sign, but I haven't seen her bunt yet. This is a girl with some power. And she hits it right into the gap between right and center field. That was famous. And this leads off here with a big double, as now the rain is coming in and trying to get our notes wet here in the broadcast. Hey, we're hanging, key, and we'll be ready to go. We don't want it to get to this electronic wet, as Joe Hope is not cheap to replace. And rain and thing it just go well together. Strabby game with one down. Seconds. So for the second straight inning, we've had people in scoring position. Yeah, the smallest one. But again, Shope, one of the pitchers we're getting all season. She's one of the reasons they are 7-0. There's a foul ball back out of play. And a little bit of rain falling here at Swain County High School. It's a little high for a ball that runs it 2-2. What now? In the bottom of the second. And our last regular season game in softball is going to be at Hiwassee Dam later on in the year. That pitch missing outside for a ball. That runs it full at 3-2. Hanging in there is Gabby Jones. Callan Brown is going to be on deck. Then we'll go back to the top. But let's see if we can knock in a run or two between now and then. Shope with the windup and the throw. Just missing. That's going to be ball four. That's the second walk of the day that Shope has given. Runners now for and second. with Callan Brown, catcher, stepping in wearing number 11. Pitch high for a ball. Hiwassee Dam beating Cherokee on Tuesday. Our Lady Devils losing a tough one by one run to Robbinsville on Tuesday. A game that we got the lead late in the ball game, and then Robbinsville ripped a two-run homer that won that game in the seventh inning. So quite a game it was. Again, runners on first and second. Shane Gatolster at second. Gabby Jones down at first. Foul ball off the bat of Callan Brown. Toby Burrell working hard on the nurse. Also trying to keep somewhat dry balls for the pitch of the home team. The ball aimed on the baseball diamond's door. Hanging in there. It's 1-2 out now. Base runners ready to go at first and second. On any kind of a ball put in play, that one high and outside for a ball to the count. Again, kind of a light out of the pit up. But hope the baseball and the softball today. Right now, that's a question. Pitch low for a ball into the Dunn's Hall for the close and watch the game in cars. Of course, we're on the internet. Foul ball down the first base side here at Maroon Devil Network. If you're on the internet, we are glad to have you listening and watching. A lot of foul ball, softball and baseball. I have of baseballs and softballs. Another foul ball. If it hits that grass, yep, it's going to get a little wet. And every time that happens, and a ball that's been dried by some of the folks over on the dugout goes so far. These balls are going to soak in a little rain. Swing and a miss, and that's going to be strike three, and that's going to be two down now for our Lady Devils. So Callan swung hard, and that's going to be strikeout number four on the day for Haley Shipp. And that'll bring our top of the lineup back to the plate, Grace Cabe. Got a one. Kicking on deeper. Scoring out of the down, 6-0. Foul ball right behind, right back to the concession stand. And I tell you, as the coaches will tell you, these softballs and baseballs aren't cheap. They try to have a good supply on hand, but of course, the softballs are that bright, fluorescent, greenish-yellow, almost a chartreuse, if you know what I mean. Meanwhile, the baseball next door, we can already see, is getting really dingy. Hard to keep the baseballs that nice, solid white on a day like today with the ground getting a little wet and the baseballs getting a little wet. They're going to soak up some moisture and some as a pitch in. And that misses for a ball. Oh, it's going to call a strike. Again, that up a little slow on a strike calls. 1-2 the count to Grace Cabe, our sophomore shortstop. Grace digging in. Here we go with a pitch, and it's going to be outside for a ball. 2-2. Remember, our Lady Devils' next home game coming up next week with Blue Ridge here at home. That's going to be on March 29, and then on the road, three in a row, Pisgah, Hayesville, Cherokee, three in a row on the road. And then after that, only three home games with Smoky Mountain, Andrews, and Murphy. Got a lot of road games coming up for the Lady Devils. Hanging in there, taking her cuts with a 2-2 count. Grace Cabe, runners at first and second. Can we get on the scoreboard? Swing and a miss. That's going to be strike three, so we strand a couple. We've played two, and the Lady Eagles in front, 6-0. Fans, welcome back. We've played a couple here between our Lady Devils and the Lady Eagles of Hiwassee Dam. It's 6-0 after two. As we jump into the top of the third inning, our Lady Devils still looking for that first run on the scoreboard. And now we've got to try to keep Hiwassee Dam at bay here. And there's a well-hit ball. It's going to be, just off the glove of our center fielder. Good recovery, though. Knocking it down and getting back in. She is their flex player, actually. She's going to come on and pinch run now. They only, as we mentioned, Hiwassee Dam only has two players on the bench to join their regular crew here. And we've already seen both their pinch runners come on and participate. So got a runner on, no out. Top of her, still some line here, but for all, third day hanging in there. Right? Number one team in the state at their own game here with some good pitching and so. There for a strike. The Taylor gets one in there. 1-1 the count now with no out and a runner at first base for the Lady Eagles. With a windup and the throw, going to be a little high. People batting now for now. We've already had to 9-55. Samantha flied out left field. Now there, Aaron Day. Kind of the way it's kind of right now, likely is into the defense's field. There's a ball that came out of her hands. That is, the bat gets a little, and boy, there are some dangerous possibilities when you've got some rain involved. The ball gets slick, the grass is going on, but again, lightning going kind of sideways, again, right into the face of our defense. There's a little blooper caught at the shortstop. Easy out. Good job over there defensively by Grace Cabe. So one down now, and we go back to the top of the lineup, Kaylee Wiggins, who has been on once. She got on with an error last time. Both teams have had one error today. Again, that's unofficial scoring, of course. Always try to err on the side of the fielder if I can, unless it's too obvious. There's a well-hit ball right up the middle, and it's going to be caught on the hot end of second base. What a play defensively. Our center fielder came through to second. Almost, but again, was single. Cameron Forrester, who has hit the ball well two times, a big double, and she flied to left field last time, but she got a double to start five. So Eddie Light Rain, now Taylor Day, gets ready to bring it. Second pitch, it's a base as he reduced. A good two out now. So our level's looking for a possible first opportunity to keep Hiwassee Dam off the scoreboard here. Batting now is going to be Macy Sienna, who has walked and grounded to third base in two times. She's their number three hitter and starting first baseman. Runners on first and second. And as we've seen already, Hiwassee Dam, much like our Lady Devils, very aggressive running. They're going to bring a runner if that ball gets through the infield. They're going to bring that runner from second around third. You can almost count on it. Pitch slow for a ball. So our infielders and outfielders trying to be on their toes as the rain continues to fall. Very steady here. Not hard, but steady. But both games, baseball and softball, playing on. Pitch for a ball, 2-0. Taylor Day, of course, very conscious of the ability of Macy Sienna, number three, Haley Shope, number four, and Alisa Floyd, number five, 3, 4, and 5 batters for Hiwassee Dam. Very, very dangerous. Really good hitters. Pitch in. Call strike. 2-1 now. Outfielders on their toes, as are the defensive infielders. There's a ball in play over to third base. Now we're first, and it's going to be in time. So our Lady Devils keep Hiwassee Dam off the scoreboard as they strand a couple. And we go to the bottom of the third with our score, Lady Eagles 6, our Lady Devils 0. We'll be back. Fans, here we go. We're on the bottom of the third. Our Lady Devils trying to get that first run across the scoreboard here on Haley Shope, one of the best pitchers in the state, bringing it for Hiawassee Dams Lady Eagles this afternoon. And in the batter's box is going to be number 25, Aaron Jenkins, our junior left fielder who hit a pop foul, and the catcher was able to catch it. Her last time at bat, she digs in. Base is empty, no out. Getting underway, bottom of the third inning with the Lady Eagles in front 6-0. Pitch on the dirt for a ball. Following Aaron is going to be Sydney Call hitting third and Alyssa Smith hitting fourth. A couple of juniors and a sophomore hitting here in the third inning. Again, only one senior on this year's edition of Lady Devil Softball. And, of course, Caitlin Dills, our senior designated player, the lone senior on the team. And that pitch is going to be in for a ball. So a quick 3-0 count as Aaron Jenkins making Haley Shope work here. Shope steps back in, brings it all. Attempted at the back of Aaron Jenkins. Our Devils have had bases in scoring just every inning. Had him on second, had him on third, but just can't get that first one across the plate. And I have a feeling if we could really start tagging Haley Shope, that this could turn into one good softball game this afternoon. As we mentioned last year, when Hiawassee Dam, again, a great team last year that played for the state championship, we went to their place and it was a 3-1 ball game. We played them toe-to-toe right down to the wire last year. There's a bunt foul down the third base side. Coach Toby Burrell getting in his fielding practice over there as well. As the rain again continues to fall, it's not hard, but it's just a steady kind of a steady light rain, if you will. But again, very steady. It's not a sprinkle. It's a steady light rain here at Swain County High School. Pitch high for a ball. That's going to be ball four. So another walk on the day as Aaron Jenkins is on. That's walk number three given up by Haley Shope. Sydney Call batting. Sydney got on with an error last time. The only, again, non-official error charged on Hiawassee Dam here this afternoon. Dig it in as the wind continues to blow. Sydney Call takes pitch number one for a ball. Talking to our friends Joe Holt and Scotty McMahon here. Got a lot of basketball coming up tonight. Sweet 16 play gets underway. Got four games coming up tonight. And I think tonight's play, just to change sports for a moment, I think tonight's play is the tougher of the two nights. I think tonight's games are just going to be really fun to watch. You got Kansas, Maryland. You got Oregon and Duke. You got Oklahoma and Texas A&M. Some outstanding play tonight. Of course, Villanova playing tonight as well. And that's 3-0 the count. So our Lady Devils really making Shope throw a lot of pitches here today. And, of course, for you Tar Heel fans, North Carolina plays on Friday night at 10 o'clock. You know, so he does run four run with a chance to see breakthrough and get some runs here. Taking pitch one for us. Haley Shope, a very hard-throwing right-hander, gets it to upper 50s. Pitch that just tanked their batter up. And, again, you feel sorry for the bat. Brings that fastball, then she puts that in there that just makes you your ankles trying to get to it. 0-2 quickly now. Alyssa hanging in there, side for a ball. So a lot of good basketball this week tonight. Four games tomorrow night, two games Saturday, two games Sunday, and the final four is set. March Madness, it is just a great. Oh, and there's another breaking pitch. They got Alyssa, and that's going to be strike three. One down, though. That's the first out here with Caitlin Bills coming up, and Breyer beginning on deck with two and one out here on the bottom of the third. 6-0 Eagle lead over the Lady Devils. A lot of wet players out there. You can see the there's a foul ball off the bat of Caitlin Dills. You can see all the girls, especially that have the ponytails, the long hair. It's just it is getting wet out there today, and some very wet jerseys, as Joe can see on the right fielder for Hiawassee Dam. Everybody's wet, very wet here. Oh, another breaking pitch, another off-speed pitch fouled off the bat of Caitlin. And all of a sudden, percent options. Yeah, she was that really tiring knots. 0-2, one down. 0-2 Pittman, the fastball, and this one's outside. Now the windup and the throw from Shope fouled off. Hanging Dills taking her 1-2 the count. And our only senior, here's Lady Devil softball, the only senior on the squad. As we mentioned, we have a bunch of juniors on this team. Only one senior. Got a couple of freshmen. So a junior this year. They're all the third to that one because it's tough. And again, Coach Toby Burrell and our girls in the dugout trying to keep the softballs as dry as possible. Got a towel over there, and just about every time a ball is in play, you got to switch them out. Pitch for a ball. Now 2-2 the count. So again, Haley Shope having to throw a lot of pitches here. I mean, we don't have a lot of hits on the day. As a matter of fact, we have one official hit, according to my stats. That's the running. Hang on to third base. Good job, Aaron Jenny. Call at second. Willie one. And we got a change. But our batters are really making a lot of pitches. She run a lot of ball days. In fact, we have four walks again before it. There's another walk. Caitlin is on. That'll be third inning. He maybe looks like one of his players is going to pull on a helmet. He's going to pinch run. Caitlin Dills is checking out of the lineup now, and coming in is going to be Ayanna West. So Ayanna, a freshman, one of the freshmen coming in to pitch run. So she steps in for Caitlin. And Breyer getting ready to step back in the box now with a 6-0 lead in favor of Hiawassee Dam, bottom of the third. Baseball and softball going on in the rain here this afternoon. But if it doesn't get any worse than this, I have an idea. Both games could very well run the count 2-2. And again, talking about the moisture as Haley takes her own, looks like a handkerchief or maybe just a washcloth out of her pocket, trying to wipe the softball off. When it's the least bit damp, I know it's got to be harder to control. Pitch high for a ball, and that's going to run it full at 3-2. Hiawassee Dam on the verge of walking in their first run of the day by the Lady Devils. Bases full, one, and all three bases via the freebie. 3-1 by Shope. Now the windup and the throw. Oh, that's going to be popped up, and it should be an easy play. It is down to second base, so that's going to be two out. So now we have two out and still the bases loaded as Breyer pops it out to second base. And Shaney Katalster with the big double earlier, a big double now would score a couple. And as we mentioned, if you hit a line drive into this wet grass, that thing just hydroplanes and it takes off. I mean, it really, it's just like the ball hits another gear and it's hard to handle. That pitch again, bases loaded. So now this can go to any base to get out three. With two down, our Lady Devils trying to get that first run across the plate here. Again, we've had opportunities every inning, but still no runs on that score. One ball, foul. The third baseman coming over to get it. And you're seeing this more often now. So the baseman, as you can see, with a face mask on. The shortstop also for Hiawassee Dam with a face mask. You're seeing that more from the interior infielders, because they're pretty close to that bat. Ball dirt. Oh, the take. Oh, ball in the dirt gets through, and we've got a run on the board, our first run of the day here. So now it's a 6-1 ball game, and a good job scoring from third base. Now runners on second and third. We want a chance still to knock in a hit. So again, good coaching, good base running. Our girls still not afraid to send them. As that ball got through, and oh, swing and a miss again, that off-speed pitch in the dirt. We can see we're over on the baseball diamond, the area around home plate getting a little bit wet, but still nothing muddy as far as that goes. But both, of course, our Lady Devils and Maroon Devils and balls somewhat dry. And here we go. Shaney showing bunt, but she rears back and swing and a miss. And that's going to be strike number three. So we get a run, but we leave two stranded. And we go to the top of the fourth inning. It's Hiwassee Dam 6, our Lady Devils 1. We'll be right back. Been two times. Let's see if we can get her out one more time and strand two base runners. Taylor Day, the windup. There's a ground ball to second base. Can we get it done? Yes, we can. Hiwassee Dam strands two, and we go to the bottom of the fourth with our score. Hiwassee Dam 7, our Lady Devils 1. We'll be back. And this fastball again, swing and a miss for two quick strikes. Now on leadoff hitter Grace Cabe, our sophomore shortstop. But again, a runner on first and only one out. And we've had people on base every inning. Just not a whole lot of runs to show for it with a 7-1 score. Pitch outside for a ball. Jumping off down there is down at first base, Gabby Jones. Gabby, of course, will take off at any given opportunity. Pitch in. Oh, that breaking pitch again, actually in the dirt, swung on and hit in play at first and safe at first base. Wow, they couldn't get it done in time. So a good job, an infield single, if you will, I have to believe, for Grace Cabe. Some might call that just a defensive error. But that ball was almost in the dirt. I'm not sure how Grace got a piece of it, but she did put it in play. And Hiwassee Dam just couldn't get the play made at first base and only one out. Then it's going to be Jenkins who has popped out for and this bunt foul. But again, playing the small ball with Jenkins and call on deck. 7-1 ball been going on for pretty much the second inning on. I think we might have got the first inning in, and then the rain started, and it's been coming down ever since. There's a stab at it. They're going to call that a strike on the attempted bunt. So now two quick strikes on Aaron Jenkins, trying to move these base runners around at first and second. Down at second, Gabby Jones. Oh, it's Grace Cabe. Our Lady Devils trying to keep pace with Hiwassee Dam, Robbinsville, and Rosman in the Smoky Mountain Conference standings. Again, off-speed pitch, going to be in for a ball. And now the count goes 2-2 after being 0-2. So Aaron Jenkins hanging in there. Baseball still being played just to our left. And they continue to work on the field as the infield gets a little wet, especially around the batter's box. And that's going to be strike three. So now two outs as Aaron Jenkins with a strikeout. And Sydney Call, the batter, Sydney in two times, has got on with an error and walked. But again, we still have runners at first and second, with two out on a chance to put a run on the board or two. Pitch in for a call strike. Stepping out of the box is going to be Sydney Call, our junior second baseman. Now digging in against Haley Shope. Again, Shope a little bit prone to give up walks. There's a foul ball, but she's inning. She actually walked three. Inning before that, she walked one. Inning before that, she walked one. So now, two techniques to butter Gordon, but she's here with me. There's a little cost there on that wet grass as we did, and rightfully so. Pitch in. Fastball missing low. Again, Alyssa Smith, our sophomore right fielder, digging in. And our girls chattering over in the dugout. Ball in play, down to first base. And we go to the top of the fifth. Our score, Hiwassee Dam 7, our Lady Devil 2. We'll be right back.
Swain County Schools. Your contribution to the Marin Song Fund will help projects. Not all projects can be supported by state or local funding, so the Marin Strong Fund was established to help fund programs that would otherwise be canceled. A few of these programs supported by the Marin Strong Fund are the Summer STEM Tutor to Interact with New Technology and the One-to-One Technology Initiative that supplies all students before and up with their own personal laptop. And is doing through our social media outlets such as Facebook and the Maroon Devils Network. Thanks for all your support. The Maroon Devils and Swain Schools is a 501c3 nonprofit organization.
Fans, welcome back as we have played four in the rain here. Well, three innings in the rain. We played the first inning without rain, but we're now entering the top of the fifth inning, still raining, and the girls are still playing, and the boys are too next door in baseball. A lot of fans have left. A lot of fans have headed out to their cars so they can watch in the cars, and those are diehard fans. Some fans are hanging out here, rolling out baseball and baseball, softball. And but it's a ball game. Our late hanging tough. As we go to the inning, Ohio will be on the back here. Taylor with a windup and the throw. Pitch is going to be high for a ball. And off here in the top of the fifth. Leading off is their leadoff batter, actually, Keely Wiggin, who's on one for three. Single, got on with an error three times. But again, Hiwassee the M had that big first inning one, and that is the difference. Otherwise, it'd be a 2-2 ball game. But they put five on in the first. Wiggin on her second hit in a row. And again, rank continue fall. Dur. Reclined trip. Amen. Haley. And those girls get four schools rain. Back line for a spot. Shut up for the Greens. And again, the balls have got to be getting things in it. Wind up on the throw. Pitch off for a ball. Runner pulls up first. Now the pitchers for both teams. I've got to. Taylor Day battling against the number one ranked team in the state in the 1A softball coaches poll. There's a shot right at second base. Oh, back to first, not in time, but got the batter. Good defense out there. And want to say goodbye to our buddy Scotty McMahon heading out of here. It's a cool, wet, nasty evening, I can tell you. it's a nasty. It's off to our players out there battling in this chilly, wet playing conditions. One down now. It's out with Waller Day brings strikes. And gather it two quick line drives and two quick. And see the pitcher, he likes it. Hailing on the dog once, went on twice. Single, it's a line, got up. Now wind up for a hard shot out of the first easy number three. So a good job defensively. As again, we keep Hiwassee Dam to score. We go to the fifth inning with a score. Hiwassee Dam 7, one Lady Devils 2. We'll be back to this timeout. Softball fans, here we go. We're on the bottom of the fifth inning, and yes, we're still playing in the rain here at Swain County High School as our Lady Devils dig in with a 7-2 deficit right now to Hiwassee Dam, but trying to hang tough. A lot of softball still to play unless it just starts really pouring down. Of course, now I believe, and I think I'm correct on this, once you get into the fifth inning, and if the game is called because of weather, I believe it stands as an official game. I think that's correct. But anyway, here we go. Looks like we're going to get five complete innings in anyway. And stepping in to hit now for our Lady Devils, number 32, Caitlin Dills. Caitlin has struck out and walked on the day. Let's see if she can get on base. We've had runners on every inning Foul ball. As Haley Shope keeps pitching for Hiwassee Dam. She's pitched a solid ball game, as you might guess, being one of the top pitchers in the entire state. As she led them to the state 1A championship series last year, and they actually won game one, but then lost games two and three to North Duplin, as they were the state runner-ups last year on the 1A playoffs. And they are ranked number one in the state poll right now. Of course, our Lady Devils would like to knock them off their undefeated perch, as they are 7-0. 2-2 the count now with no out here on the bottom of the fifth inning on Caitlin. Here's the pitch from Shope. Foul ball again. Right down the first baseline. And our girls again trying to hang in there and whip these folks. Kayla Jones down there. Always ready to jump out of the way at first base. And she had to on that one. Baseball player still playing. Again, our baseball scoreboard out of order, so we don't know the score over there, but both teams have been putting runs up. And they're still playing. Their game actually started a little bit before our game. We were waiting on the officials to show up. But we got them and got started. And we're still going at it. Swing and a miss. And that's going to be out number one, is big cut by Caitlin Dills. And now Briar Buchanan batting. Briar struck out and popped to second base in two trips. Shani Katalster is going to be on deck behind her. Here on this Thursday, we appreciate Joe Holt doing all the great camera work as always. Pitch in, and that's going to be a strike. 0-1 the count. And again, we've said it all day. Taylor Day has been around the strike zone a lot today. Of course, Haley Shope has not. Haley gets that strike in there, but Haley is, now last inning, she really settled down, I think. There's a shot right by Kayla again down on the first base side. But last inning, Shope settled down some and regained her strike zone. But the inning before that, she actually walked three Lady Devil hitters. And we got a run out of that. But last inning, she settled down and pretty much had our number. But we're in the fifth inning here. Let's see if we can add another run. There's a ball right in front of the plate. Shope picks it up, fires to first. That's going to be out two. So, again, a little bunt right in front of the plate off the bat of Breyer, and that's out two. Shani Katalster, who has one of our two doubles on the day. Shani has a double, and Sydney Call has a double. Gabby Jones has a single. Unofficially, those are our three hits on the day off Haley Shope, the star right-handed pitcher for Hiwassee Dam. Pitch in, low for a ball. With two out, nobody on. And I believe, I'm pretty sure this is correct, this is the only inning so far we have not had base runners. And most of the time, multiple base runners. But nobody on right now with two out. Pitch in, going to be in for a strike. And let's see if Shani can change that. She's had a hot bat lately. Had the two-run homer against Robbinsville. Has a double today. And she's been whacking that softball around. That one in the dirt. Off-speed pitch. It's kind of funny. A couple of innings ago, we saw Shope really use the off-speed pitch and really tie our batters up. And last inning, she went back to the fastball. So she really has been mixing it up somewhat, but she has a wicked off-speed changeup. Of course, her fastball is pretty effective, too, when it's in the strike zone. Here comes the speed, going to be low for a ball. Now it runs 3-1, the count with two out here on the bottom of the fifth inning. So after we play five, I'm pretty sure that makes it an official game if we were to get stopped by rain. Now Shani shows that bunt sign. She does that a lot, but then she rears back and takes it outside for a ball. That's going to be ball four. So another walk given up by Shope. As Shani is on deck, so every inning we've had a person on base. And now Gabby Jones, who had a single last time, steps in with two out. I tell you, you got to be a pretty good fan to hang out on this chilly, cold, wet weather here. It's not cold, but it's chilly enough, especially if you're wet. And every player out here today is pretty much wet to the bone. You can believe it on the baseball and softball fields, unless you're in the dugout and unable to play. Pitch in for a ball. But now they're going to call it a strike, 1-1. Again, an umpire throws me. He doesn't call it immediate strike. It's a delayed right hand he throws out there. So 1-1 the count. Pitch in for a ball, this time low in the dirt. As Shaney jumps off first base a little bit. And the rain continues to, it's a steady rain. As you can see on the camera from Joe Holt, if you look into the lights, you can really see the rain. We've had it since the second inning. And it's been a steady rain. The baseball game is over next door. We're seeing them hang it up. We're not sure of a score. We'll try to find out if we won or lost against Hiwassee Dam in the baseball game. But they actually did start a little bit before we did. And we're playing here in the fifth inning. Bottom of the fifth, 2 out, 3-1 the count. Hanging in there, Gabby Jones, who got a base hit last time, trying to get on, knock Shaney Katalster around here. And she fouls it off. Shaney is going to have to come back to first base. 7-2 our score here. We hope our boys won next door. We saw a lot of activity there offensively by both teams, so we know there were no goose eggs on the scoreboard over there, as we see O'Neill Blankenship and Tyler Schuler talking it over with their folks. But the field here on the softball diamond is still in very good shape. There's Shaney taking off. Yeah, well, she took off, didn't really have to, but that's a walk. As ball four is called. And again, good job at the plate for Gabby Jones. She has walked twice today. So now, again, multiple base runners. Can we get a run in? 7-2 with two out. Runners at first and second. Can we get it done? Callan Brown, our junior catcher, now in the hitter's box, ready to bring it. And it's going to be a ball high from Haley Shope with two out. Coach Toby Burrell over in the coach's box giving the signals to Callan Brown, the instructions. Shope back on the rubber and now brings it in. Foul ball, first base side. Everybody's going to have to come back. So the baseball game, they all shook hands, but they're hanging around like maybe, are they going to try to play two? I'm not sure. The lights are on here on both fields. Not sure what they're going to do on the baseball scene, but everybody's still hanging around over there. There's a pitch getting by. The runners advance to second and third now. Now our Lady Devils with a runner on third. Over there is Shaney Katalster, and Gabby Jones is at second. A base hit would make this a 7-4 ball game. And we've had this situation a couple of times. Runners on second and third where just a base hit would probably score two runs and really, really make it tight. Coach Toby Burrell looking like, okay, he's going to bring in a pinch runner. And Shaney will head to the dugout. So now going to bring in a pinch runner down at third base. And it looks like Sydney Hampton, a freshman, number 13. Sydney comes on to run. And you know Coach Burrell is going to send her at any possible opportunity. This pitch in the dirt. Sydney jumps off and gets back, and we can already see she is quick. So now, 2 out, 3-1 the count. Lady Devils trying to add to the scoreboard. We're down by 5 runs, 7-2 at the bottom of the fifth inning. Shope now with a wind. Oh, now the umpire says hold up as stepping out of the box is going to be Callan. Battling against the number one team in our conference right now in the standings and also ranked number one in the state coaches poll. Here comes the pitch, and it's going to be in for a strike. That'll run at 3-2. Full count now. And the runners probably will be going. And it looks like the baseball is over. Looks like the guys are loading up and getting ready to call it a day for the most part. Of course, the Hiwassee Dam boys are staying in the dugout till the girls' game is over. I think they all came over on probably the same bus. And there's ball four, and the bases are loaded again. Ball four, another walk. So Callan Brown, and that is three walks in a row. Shaney, Gabby, and Callan now have all walked, and Grace Cabe will bat with two out, and the bases loaded. A base hit again here would bring in a couple. So the walk has plagued Hiwassee Dam again. And coming out, Coach Helton wants to talk it over with his girls and find out where his pitcher is, and we'll take a timeout. Stay with us, fans. We'll be right back. Fans, here we go after the timeout now. Bases loaded, two out. Three consecutive walks given up by Hiwassee Dam. And here comes the pitch. Fouled off down the first base side right on top of the baseball dugout. And you can see the rain fly up when that softball hit the tin roof. I guess it's tin. Could be fiberglass. But anyway, it has been a wet afternoon here. Steady rain since the second inning. Thank goodness no thunder or lightning or would have been gone. Steady rain, digging in. Grace, foul ball again down the first base side. Again, Grace Cabe has walked and struck out in two times and trying to get the ball in play to get a run around. 7-2 Hiwassee Dam lead. Two strikes and two out now, but again, the base is loaded. We have had so many opportunities here with runners on base. So many situations. There's a ball high. And you know, if the ball gets by the catcher down at third base, Sydney is going to take off. And she is quick. Right behind her, Gabby Jones. And over here is Callan Brown at first. Now Shope trying to pitch the Lady Eagles out of this inning. The windup off-speed pitch too high. And she has used that as a real weapon today. That off-speed pitch has been tough, but Grace wisely laid off that floater. Now 2-2 the count, two out. Pitch in, strike three called, and we leave the bases loaded here on the bottom of the fifth inning. Fans, stay tuned. We'll go to the top of the sixth. It's Hiwassee Dam 7, Swain High 2. We'll be back on the Maroon Devils Network. Fans, we're live and in living color here on a Thursday evening as the first pitch is going to be high for a ball as our Lady Devils will be back on defense here on the top of the sixth inning in a 7-2 ball game. Hiwassee Dam has led the whole day. They scored 5 in the first inning, but since then it's been a standoff. 7-2 score as our Lady Devils have scored 1 in the third and 1 in the fourth, but now we're in the top of the sixth inning, 7-2. And now if the weather really gets hard as far as the rain goes, this would be an official game, I believe, once you've played 5 full innings of play. And we're going to be playing Hiwassee Dam again at their place the last game of the regular season. Pitch in for a ball from Taylor Day. Again, these girls are just, they're just wet. Of course, the boys have been finished. Now, by the way, our boys did win. The Swain boys, the Maroon Devils beat Hiwassee Dam. I believe the score was either 10-4 or 10-5, but nice win for our boys. And the baseball game next door, they've already finished up and got a win in the column for Coach Tyler Schuler. Congratulations to the boys over there. Now Taylor Day with a windup on a 2-2 count. And there's a ground ball foul down the third base side. But again, we've had a less than beautiful day here. We've had rain since the second inning. We've had wind. It's definitely on the chilly side. And not your ideal kind of a day, if you know what I mean. But our girls are hanging tough for both teams. I mean, they're both out there in the same weather for Swain and Hiwassee Dam. Pitch, ball, four. No, it's going to be ball 3. 3-2 the count now. Hiwassee Dam batting here on the top of the sixth inning with a 7-2 lead. And pitch in, and this is going to be well hit all the way to the fence in left center field. Rounding first, heading to second with a stand-up double. Huge hit for Hiwassee Dam. And that's Samantha Willingham, a big double. And they have had, let's see, 1, 2, 3 doubles on the day with a few singles scattered in. And we'll go to the top of the lineup now, I believe, and that's going to be Kaylee Wiggins, who got on with a base hit last time for the Lady Eagles. So, again, 99, unusual, or check that, to, yes, 99 down there for Hiwassee Dam. Down to second base, foul ball on the third base side, and that one's going to be, no, they're going to call it fair. That one's in for a hit. Runners in and down at second base now with a stand-up double is going to be Savannah Willis. So Hiwassee Dam coming back with a vengeance here with a run, and they are on the scoreboard now 8-2 in the top of the sixth, and nobody out. And the windup and the throw, another base hit. Bang, 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 and this one's go to the fence. This one's going to go to the fence. We've got another run in, and now coming around second into third with a stand-up triple. Hiwassee Dam all of a sudden has just unloaded the bats. 3 straight hits in a row, the first time all day they have done that. And all of a sudden it's a 9-2 ball game. And now it looks like they're going to have a pinch hitter coming up. It's going to be Brittany Sims. But all of a sudden, they just ripped the cover off the ball. That was Megan Golden with that stand-up triple. It was a base hit, but it got by our right fielder, made it into the fence. But as we mentioned, when the grass is wet and that ball hits the grass, whether it's a baseball or a softball, especially if it has any velocity, it really takes off when it hits the grass, and it just gives outfielders fits trying to get a glove on it. But Hiwassee Dam now is going to bring on a pinch hitter. The coaches are being notified by the plate ump, and we'll get back to action here with a 9-2 lead. But now Hiwassee Dam on the verge of making this a ball game. They have a runner on third and a 10-run limit at the plate, if you will. So now, here we go, 9-2, nobody out. Top of the sixth inning. Hiwassee Dam, 3 straight hits. They hit this one down to second base, a slow roller on to first, and is it going to be in time? Yes. So that's going to be out number 1, but they score run number 10. So a three-run inning here in the sixth. And so now one out, and stepping up to bat for Hiwassee Dam is going to be Samantha Willingham, who already has a double on the day. And now the bases are empty with one out. Pitch high from Taylor Day, who's been a real Trojan out there pitching in this kind of weather with wet softballs and pitching against the number one ranked team in the state. The windup on the throw, pitch high for a ball, 2-0 the count. A 10-2 Hiwassee Dam lead. Now they have struck for three in a row here in the top of the sixth inning. Ground ball to shortstop, on over to first in time. Good play defensively as Grace Cabe makes it look easy over there. Two out now here on the top of the sixth. As now batting is going to be their ace pitcher. Not checking that. It's going to be Kaylee Wiggins. They're top of the lineup batting now. So Kaylee batting with two out, nobody on. And an eight-run Hiwassee Dam lead here on the top of the sixth inning. Taylor Day with a windup and the throw. Oh, that was in for a strike, 0-1 the count. Taylor has been around the strike zone all day. Pitch outside for a ball, and the wind is still blowing, and the rain is still coming down. Not a hard rain, but just a steady rain that we've had, steady light rain since the second inning on. Pitch in the dirt. In the baseball game, the guys were able to get their game in, winning today, and good win again for our Maroon Devils over Hiwassee Dam. A lot of offensive fireworks over there. I think we put 10 runs on the board and had a good day offensively for our guys over there. Pitch in, high for a ball. Count runs 3-1 now. Base is empty, two out. We'll see if we can keep Hiwassee Dam from getting anything else. They've already put three on the board here in this sixth inning. Pitch inside for a ball. Oh, they're going to call it a strike, 3-2. Count runs full. That one looked high and tight, but hey, Taylor Day said, I love it. It was a strike. The windup and the throw. This one is well hit as well, and it's going to be in the gap between right and center field into second base with a stand-up double. Is going to be the leadoff batter, Kaylee Wiggins. That's her third hit on the day for Hiwassee Dam, and that's going to bring up Cameron Forrester. Cameron on the day has hit a double, but then lined it right at somebody the next three times. She has flied out to left field, popped out to second base, and lined out to second base. Now check this. I believe we may have another change in the batting lineup here for Hiwassee Dam. On deck is going to be Macy Senna. As Hiwassee Dam gets the coaching signals from Coach Helton over at third base. Now digging in, they're going to stay with Cameron Forrester. She's going to get ready to go. Ball is going to be in, low for a ball. Runner on second with two out. Our Lady Devils trying to hang in here and keep Hiwassee Dam from getting this win here in the sixth inning. Pitch outside for a ball. Of course, you know, in softball and baseball, too, I'm sure the 10-run rule, if you get in front by 10 after five innings, the game is done. Windup and the throw. Did it get the batter? She did a little dance and I think avoided being hit by the pitch. We've only had one, I believe, all day. But, again, it's quite a chore pitching a softball that is wet. Trying to keep it in the strike zone. Now the rain actually almost seemed like it's let up a little bit, even though there's still a steady light rain here. Not going to help any of these players. They're already soaked pretty much to the bone here. Pitch in for a strike. 3-1 as the batter just let that one float by. Wasn't going after that one on the 3-0. Now the runner at third. And again, digging in, that's going to be Cameron Forrester. They're starting second baseman. Uh-oh, this one is high. This one is against the fence. It almost got out of the park. She rounds second. She's going to come into third. And I really had a bad feeling when that ball left her bat. That ball was a foot from going over the fence and giving Hiwassee Dam that 10-run lead. Now it's 11-2 at third base with two out. Now stepping in, it's going to be Macy Sienna. On the day, though, does not have a single hit. She has walked, grounded to third twice, and lined out to the pitcher. So let's see if we can get her out and stay alive in this 11-2 ball game with two out in the top of the sixth inning. Some of the baseball guys sticking around to watch the girls here. As again, the rain has kind of let up a little bit, believe it or not, after raining pretty steady since the second. The forecasters say the heavy stuff is coming tonight. We'll see. As we saw a big line of yellow on the radar heading in from Chattanooga earlier this afternoon. Pitch in for a ball. 3-0 the count now. Taylor Day working hard. Oh, pitch in for a strike. Caught the outside corner just about every time today that Taylor Day has run a count 3-0. The Hiwassee Dam batters have taken the pitch, and it's been a strike just about every time. Now 3-1, two out. Ball gets by, runner coming. That could be the ball game. That makes it a 12-2 lead. The runner scored from third. And let's see what the officials decide. But we're on the top of the inning, so we've got to play out the bottom of the sixth inning. So we do get another chance at bat to avoid a potential faster inning than we wanted here this afternoon. So now 12-2. Pitch in for a strike. Stepping into the box now again. Hiwassee Dam has had a productive inning here, putting five on the board here in the sixth inning. 12-2 ball game, but our Lady Devils will hit in the bottom of the sixth inning. Pitch outside for a ball. As Haley Shope, who has been pitching all afternoon for Hiwassee Dam, is at the plate. And a runner down at first base. Taylor with a windup and the pitch. This one is well hit. This one is out of here. A two-run homer for Haley Shope. And that's not the first time in her career that has happened, as she just lined one over left center field. The ball is out there past the light pole as we see a gentleman retrieve the ball, and that makes it a 14-2 ball game. But all of a sudden, Hiwassee Dam has just exploded now for seven runs here in the sixth inning. And the bases are empty now with two out. So a 7-2 game has all of a sudden turned into a 14-2 ball game here. But that left the bat. And that was a line shot. That one didn't hang up in the air. It took off. And that's the way it is. Pitch in for a ball now. Batting right behind Haley Shope is going to be Alicia Floyd, who has had a productive day, 3 of 4 on the day. Two singles, a double, and a walk on the afternoon. With the bases empty and two out, pitch in for a ball. But it has been a struggle here in the sixth inning defensively for our girls to get Hiwassee Dam out of the inning. Two out now. Pitch in for a ball. 3-0 the count. And Taylor Day has done this a few times this inning, but every time she brings a strike. And Hiwassee Dam has been taking just about every time it's been a 3-0 count. And we'll see if that's the case with Alicia Floyd here. And that's going to be ball four. So a walk, and Floyd is on, and that's going to bring up Savannah Willis, who has had a big day as well. Savannah with two singles, a double, and a strikeout. And Coach Toby Burrell is coming on, and we'll see if there's going to be a potential change or maybe just to settle down Taylor a little bit. It's been a tough afternoon, and looks like there's going to be a pitching change. So Taylor is going to be done for the day, I believe, And I'm sure she's got to be wearing down a little bit. Taylor pitched a good ball game on Tuesday against Robbinsville when Robbinsville came back and got us in the seventh after we had fought back to take the lead. But obviously, Taylor has been hit pretty hard here in this sixth inning as Hiwassee Dam has struck for 7-1. So while we warm up, we're going to take a break, and we'll be right back after this timeout. After the timeout, the Lady Devils with a pitching change. Coming on now is we have a 14-2 ball game, and the pitch is going to be in. Coming on is going to be Megan Ammons, a junior. Megan coming on to pitch wearing number 8. Again, this is a junior-dominated team, a bunch of juniors on this year's Lady Devil softball team. Hiwassee Dam hitting with 2 out, runner on first. High pop-up could be in play, and Shaney is there, and I believe she's got it. And we get out of this inning, but, boy, it was a tough one. As Hiwassee Dam struck for 7, it's now 14-2, but our Lady Devils still alive. We'll see if we can keep this one going in the bottom of the 6th when we come back. Fans, here we go. Bottom of the sixth inning. Our Lady Devils right now kind of with our backs against the wall, if you will, as Hiwassee Dam stuck seven runs on the scoreboard there in the top of the sixth inning to make it a 14-2 game. Now, as you know, there is a 10-run rule, so we've got to have at least three runs here to keep this game alive. And starting it off here in the bottom of the sixth inning is going to be junior left fielder Aaron Jenkins here. Shope still pitching for Hiwassee Dam. There's a bunt foul down the third base side right into the dugout, and they'll change balls here. We've had some young ladies very busy with a towel over there trying to keep the softballs as dry as possible. And believe it or not, the rain has slacked up. It's barely just kind of a light drizzle now. We've had some steady rain for most of the game, but now just a very light drizzle. And let's see if we can hang in there. Pitch is going to be high for a ball. Haley Shope has been very effective the last couple of innings. We didn't get any in the fifth, even though we loaded the bases. Wow, I've had so many opportunities today with people on base, but unable to bring them in. That's been our Achilles heel, if you will. Bunt foul, third base side again, as Coach Toby Burrell tracks it down. So it's not been that we haven't had scoring opportunities. We just can't get those people on base across home plate here in this. Even though it seems like a runaway at 14-2, this game is much closer than that, as we have left a lot of base runners on base here this afternoon. Pitch in, and that's going to be in for a ball now. It's going to run a count 2-2. And behind Aaron, we'll have Sydney Call and Alyssa Smith here, our number 2, 3, and 4 batters here on a Thursday afternoon. Shope with a windup, and there's a ground ball foul again on the third base side. So Aaron Jenkins is not going down without a fight here. Again, our next game up for the girls, we're going to be hosting Blue Ridge right here in just a couple of days, coming around on Tuesday. So hopefully you can come on out. We'll be hosting Blue Ridge right here Tuesday, 4:30. Then on the road, three in a row, at Pisgah, at Hayesville, and that's going to be strike three as Aaron goes down. Again, three in a row, March 31st at Pisgah, April 1st on April Fool's Day, no fooling. That'll be at Hayesville, and then April 5th at Cherokee on the road before we come back home April 6th here hosting Smoky Mountain. Pitch in for a strike now with one down. Again, our Lady Devils down to our final two outs unless we can get three runs on the scoreboard to extend this game another inning. It's not for lack of enthusiasm over there in the dugout. Our girls trying to cheer our hitters on. A lot of the Hiwassee Dam boys have taken off of the bus here. Actually, they have a couple of buses up there. I see them now, but I know both teams arrived at about the same time. Foul ball, no play off the fence. Of course, that's been the way it's been going for the most part. When we play somebody, normally it's baseball and softball going on at the same time. That doesn't always happen, but it does happen a lot for our fans to come out and see some baseball and softball, and we hope you'll do that because, believe it or not, there's a swing and a miss, and that's going to be strike three, and that's going to be out two now. We're down to our final out unless we can put some runs on the board here. Down 14-2 here on the bottom of the sixth inning in the Smoky Mountain Conference game. Hiwassee Dam at 7-0. Pitch high for a ball. Stepping in is Alyssa Smith. Alyssa has struck out twice and grounded to first base in her attempts at the plate here this afternoon. Pitch in for a strike. 1-1 the count now, with a chilly wind still blowing around Swain County softball field. And you know these players who are soaking wet out there gotta be less than warm. Wind up on the throw, Shope with another strike. Two strikes now. Again, trying to hang in there, Alyssa Smith. Caitlin Dills is gonna be on deck. Caitlin Dills batting with a possibility of keeping this game going here. Pitch in, swing and a miss, strike three. And ladies and gentlemen, that's going to wind it up here this afternoon as Hiwassee Dam will stay undefeated and will retain their number one ranking here this afternoon as they win 14-2. We'll try to touch base with head coach Toby Burrell to see if he wants to chat with us on the postgame show when we return right here on the Maroon Devils Network. Hi, everybody. Welcome back here at Swain County High School. A chance to talk with head coach Toby Burrell after a tough loss here against Hiwassee Dam's Lady Eagles. And I know, Coach, the score, to me, not indicative of the ballgame. 14-2, but bottom line is, and you may totally disagree, but we just left a lot of people on base as we had people in scoring position, but just couldn't get them in.
Yeah, we didn't get a break we needed here and there, but you know what? You got to tip your hat. That's good pitching right there. Haley Shope did a great job, and that's why they're where they are. They're able to pitch you out of stuff like that because she's so good at what she does, and she gets you on the ropes and then puts you away. She's very, very good. But, yeah, we left a boatload out there. We had some opportunity to score some runs and didn't capitalize on that. And, you know, again, the first inning, Bugaboos killed us 5 runs this time in the first. That was just devastating. You know, Haley's probably not giving up 5 earned runs in a game in her career, so that puts you back against the wall from the – very start of the ball game, and you just got to dig out, and there's only so many times you can dig out of a hole. And we had some good at bats through there. I felt like Shaney had a real good at bat when she got a base hit. You know, there were some things sprinkled in there again, but it wasn't as much as the Robbinsville game was, that's for sure. And just all in all, disappointed in our effort. I think we can play better than what we showed.
Yeah, Coach, I know coming up next, I think Blue Ridge coming here to play us at Swain County, but then 3 games in a row on the road. So got a lot of road games coming up in the very near future for this team, don't we?
Yeah, well, we're road warriors. You know, that's not really an issue for us. To be honest, and I don't mean it as a criticism, but playing here is a lot like a road game, except that we get to bat last because all of the opponents' fans sit in the stands where we can hear them, and our fans are spread out everywhere. We don't ever hear our fans. So, you know, it's a lot like a road game in that regard. So we're kind of used to that atmosphere, if you will. The only difference is we don't get last bat and we don't get to get to the dressing room. Outside of that, there's not a whole lot of difference there. So, you know, not a big deal. It's going to be a tough stretch for us. So I told the girls just a little while ago, we got to make our minds up as to what kind of team we want to be and decide that and get going next week, because Blue Ridge presents a different set of problems for us than anybody. They're against them. They're trying to get the program started, so they're not at the place everybody else is. So that makes it tough. And then to turn around and play Pisgah after that, that's another tough one right there. And then we've not had good success at Hayesville the last couple of years. We've had to come from behind in the seventh inning and extra innings to win ball games over there. So that's going to be a tough one, and a close ball game over here the first time. So, you know, it doesn't get easy. It's not going to be easy at all down the stretch in Smoky Mountain Conference.
Yeah. Well, Coach, again, another good effort today. But again, go out there and get dry, because it's been a miserable day for the most part.
Well, it was raining. It rained all the way to the seventh inning, and then it quit. I don't know why God shined on us there in the seventh, but thankfully he did. But it rained steady the whole way, and it's a tough day. It's hard on Taylor to get a grip on the ball. She's fighting that grip. She's fighting the cold hands. You know, it's just tough to throw strikes, and it's tough for Haley too. But she's got bigger hands than Taylor does, and you know, so that helps her out a lot. And in that regard, and trying to keep a dry ball, but you can't do that. It's still raining. You know, it's one of those things. So, but it's a tough day weather-wise. It's a tough day opponent-wise for us.
Oh, no question, fans. That's going to wrap it up. Join us next time as we've got a lot more softball coming up for the rest of this season, and we'll be right here with it on the Maroon Devils Network.
Yeah, it was.
Thanks, man.
It was kind of miserable. I could tell it was just...